Alright guys, in case you forgot how to install everything back in its place, we made this reverse tutorial. If you want to learn how to uninstall a 7750-Z1 fan kit, make sure to watch the first video. To the right of the screen is the link. So you want to install the laser rear fan in the plastic cage. And then install the whole fan assembly on the right side of the machine on the top left corner. Alright, now screw it in place with the hidden screw on the right and the top screw on the left. Once the screws have been set in their place, you can install the laser assembly cable bracket, and that should hold the laser assembly wires in place. And finally, you can install the power wires back in their place. Now lift the high voltage power supply assembly back in its place. Make sure you pull the cables from the rear of the power supply assembly. And then you want to begin screwing the board down. Now plug the four cables that you removed earlier. You will see that each cable will only fit in its individual connector because of its length. Alright, now we can connect everything back in the low voltage power supply assembly, which includes the low voltage power supply fan. Also, don't forget to plug back in the developer fan back in its place. What you want to do is screw back the high voltage power supply metal protector. Now we can put the feeder fan back in the plastic cage and carefully run the wires back in their place. Now place the feeder fan assembly back in its original place. Don't forget to connect the yellow power cable. Line up the holes to the plastic and screw down the feeder fan assembly. Once the feeder fan has been installed, you can now install the rear mid plastic cover. Now you can install the top rear plastic cover. Now don't forget to screw it down. Now we can install the rear cover, which is held by four screws. Okay, now we can install the top cover. Carefully place it down, and you can slowly accommodate it until you line up the screw holes. Now begin screwing down the top cover before you install the right side cover. Alright, now we can install the right side cover. Also, make sure all the holes are lined up with the plastic. Now connect the control panel harness to the bridge board. Now install the control panel harness top cover. And finally, screw down the top cover, the last screw. Alright guys, that's it. Don't forget to order your parts at www.iteminkonline.com or give us a call at 1-800-367-4836. Remember, if you depend on your printer, depend on us, Item Inc. This has been another Item Inc. production how-to video. Hope you've enjoyed the tutorial.